We're talking with current R. Phils camp instructor and Cleveland Indians farmhand Eric Mock, who also played here as a member of the 2015 Governor Mifflin Mustangs when they won the Brooks County Championship right here at First Energy Stadium. 5 years ago, you were on this field as a member of the Governor Mifflin Mustangs. Kind of nice to come back as a pro, huh?
Oh yeah, great time. It's always a privilege whenever I can come out to this beautiful park. I grew up about 5-7 minutes from here, so grew up watching games and love coming out here to this great park.
Do you remember anything about that 2015 championship game?
I do. I remember tackling my buddy John Catchmark on the mound after the final out. I was at third base and just dogpiling after that, and that's a memory I won't forget.
Yeah, it's got to be nice just with everybody kind of locked down for so long to get out here and finally do some baseball-related activity, huh?
For sure. It's, you know, it's always great whenever you can work with the younger guys. This game's given me a lot, and, you know, I try to give back to the game as much as I can. And also just getting out of the house is nice. Whatever I can do to get in, out of the house and in the sun.
Do you have experience working with young kids like this, or is this something new for you?
Yeah, I do. Well, I have three younger sisters, so I grew up with them. And then I've actually been given some lessons around the area recently, working with 11 to 15-year-olds. So some of these guys today were a little bit younger, but I like working with kids for sure.
What have you been doing to keep busy besides giving some lessons and stuff?
Just staying in shape, lifting, following my lifting program and throwing, getting some time out by the pool, getting the tan in and swimming, just hanging out with family though, enjoying that time for sure.
Have the Indians let you guys know what's going on, or is it just kind of a gray area for everybody right now?
It's still sort of gray, you know. They want to wait till anything's definitive to, you know, tell us what exactly is going on. You know, it's not looking great, like there will be a full minor league season or anything like that. But we don't know if we'll be going out to our spring training site in Arizona or what. So just waiting to hear on that, but looking forward to MLB being back, if nothing else.
And of course, next year, still a lot of question marks. You played for Mahoning Valley last year. Next year, who knows if there's even going to be a league for Mahoning Valley to play in?
Yeah, for sure. It's sad with them cutting some of the lower level teams where I played in college and state college. They're talking about getting rid of the spikes, which is sad. It's sad for some communities. So we'll see what happens.
You in contact with Mike Sarbaugh at all? He's a Governor Mifflin guy, also in the area and affiliated with the Indians.
Yeah, I knew Mr. Sarbaugh, and he was a substitute teacher at our school, and I know his kids. And the Indians had us out to Progressive Field in Cleveland last year, where he's the third base coach, and we were able to talk to him on the field before the game, so it's always good to reunite with him and get to talk to him.
When we finally do get baseball back and going again, it's got to be nice knowing that Akron is affiliated with the Indians and could be playing in this ballpark maybe in another year or two, huh?
It's always been a dream of mine to play in this stadium in Double A, and hopefully I'll get to live that out in a year or two.